President Trump tonight says that he is not considering firing special counsel Robert Mueller. The president fielded some questions from reporters when he arrived at the White House from Camp David this evening, revealing that he has no plans to do that. You know, many of the president's opponents have feared that he might try and shut down the Russia investigation by canning Mueller. Well, his latest comments come after those new claims by the Trump transition team that the special counsel's office improperly obtained thousands of private emails during the Trump transition, something the president says is wrong. And there are also calls for top FBI officials now to appear before the House Judiciary Committee to answer questions about allegations of that possible bias against the president. Here's Ohio Republican Congressman Jim Jordan.
Subpoena Andrew McCabe, Bruce Strzok, Bruce Orr, his wife, and Lisa Page. And I also think the chief of staff of the FBI needs to be brought in. So let's get all the documents. Let's bring him in for depositions. And let's put him on the same witness stand that Rosenstein sat on last week and Sessions sat on a few weeks ago and ask them the same tough questions so the American people can get the answers.
And that seems to be in the works tonight. But first, let's start with the president. Joining us is Republican Congressman Ron DeSantis of Florida, who is a member of the House Judiciary Committee. So, Congressman, your reaction to what the president said just over an hour ago, about 90 minutes ago, that he will not fire Robert Mueller.
Well, you know, those were all rumors. He was not saying that. I had not heard any of that. And the thing is I look back and I don't think that Mueller should have been appointed because there was never really a crime to investigate. It's more of searching for a crime. But having said that, I think it would be politically dumb to fire him, particularly at this juncture. I don't think that they're going to make a collusion case. I know it's annoying to the White House to have to deal with this going on, but I think firing Mueller would just create a lot of political problems. Things are going, I think, fine the way they are, so I think he did the right thing.
And do you think that this will mollify? Can it mollify any of the critics, or at least reassure them that this investigation will continue?
Well, here's the thing about the investigation. I think there are a lot of very legitimate questions about the very genesis of the investigation long before Director Mueller was ever appointed. You're going back in the heart of the presidential campaign, July, August of 2016. Trump is already the Republican nominee. Hillary's the Democratic nominee. We know that the FBI got this dossier that was compiled by Christopher Steele and paid for by the Democratic Party. We're trying to get answers in Congress to figure out, okay, did the FBI pay Steele for the dossier? Did the FBI use the dossier to get any surveillance? And what about this meeting in Andrew McCabe's office where you have this agent, Peter Strzok, Lisa Page, they're talking about, oh, Trump can't possibly get elected, right? And then Strzok, after the meeting, texts Page saying, look, I wish that scenario were 100%, but we, the FBI, he means, can't take the risk of Trump getting elected. And then he alluded to needing an insurance policy to prevent it. So that is a major thing because that's just more than anti-Trump bias. That is somebody who is saying that they are going to act in accordance with their bias, interfere in an election.
Yeah, but you know what Rod Rosenstein, you know, testified to, and others are saying that, you know, there's a difference between personal beliefs and professional actions, that there were no actions that may have reflected that personal animus to Mr. Trump. Do you believe that?
Well, Mueller fired the guy, so he wouldn't have gotten removed.
He wasn't fired. He was dumped from Mueller. He's over at the Human Resources Department now.
Yeah, I mean, that's obviously a demotion. This was Mr. Super Agent. He was in charge of the Hillary investigation. Then he was in charge of the Russia investigation. And I think it's odd that, yes, you can have political opinions, but we've had questions for a year now about the lack of zealousness that went into Hillary's case.
I know the lack of zealousness. I mean, look, Strzok, apparently, Mrs. Clinton was not put under oath, right, to testify about any of that. Strzok apparently, or others, apparently changed the language from gross negligence, remember that, to extremely careless, and there's a difference in the law
and
in the handling
and
of the emails.
Strzok, yep. And I think this is even bigger than that. That Comey had a finding saying it's reasonably likely that her server was hacked by hostile foreign actors. And Strzok changed that and basically said, well, you know, we can't determine it's possible kind of deal. That really watered it down. And that was, she had already always said, oh, my server never got hacked. The FBI's initial conclusion was different. So the issue is with the bias is, yes, he was pro-Hillary, anti-Trump, but you look at that investigation, it's very questionable. It's a subject of an inspector general's investigation now. But then you look at the Russia stuff, and he's saying that they have to stop Trump, and you wonder whether they used the dossier or any of these things. They have not been willing to answer those questions.
Well, that's
for
Bruce Orr supposedly met with Christopher Steele, and that's part of the investigation. He was
during the presidential campaign.
Yeah, his wife,
so this
Nellie.
Guy is right down the street from, he's right down the hall from Sally Yates, who's the deputy AG. Why is he going to meet with Christopher Steele? I asked Rosenstein whether that meeting was authorized or not.
Well,
he would not tell me.
It apparently wasn't authorized because he didn't tell anybody. And his wife Nellie works for Fusion GPS, I guess, during the campaign or during that summer. But let me get back to one email you mentioned about Peter Strzok. I mean, and the text that called President Trump an idiot, saying it's terrifying. I mean, they also called Bernie Sanders an idiot. So he's an equal idiot opportunity idiot declaration. Here's that email you referred to. Quote, I want to believe the path you threw out for consideration in Andy's office, that there's no way he, Trump, gets elected. But I'm afraid we can't take that risk. It's like an insurance policy in the unlikely event you die before you're 40. So let's look at that for a second. I want to believe the path you threw out for consideration in Andy's office. That could be Andy McCabe. What path? What do you think they're talking about?
Well, look, I mean, we need to find out. I mean, I read that as her saying, look, he's not going to win. There's no way. He doesn't have the path to get the Electoral College. And then Strzok is saying, yeah, you know, I hear what you're saying, but we in the FBI can't take that risk. We need an insurance policy in case this guy wins.
And
so the question is,
what was
that insurance policy?
Yeah, yeah. What do you think that insurance policy is? I mean, it says it right here. It's like an insurance policy. What's it? Well, I mean, obviously, they're cooking up something. What do you think it is?
So that is why we want answers about this dossier. The FBI, neither Ray nor Rosenstein would answer. Did you pay for the dossier? Did you use the dossier to start the Russia investigation? Did you use information from the dossier to get surveillance on some of Trump's associates? And remember, as soon as Trump won, right after that, you started to have this Russia narrative take hold amongst the Democrats and the media and amongst certain elements of the bureaucracy where you had unprecedented leaking to try to damage the incoming president. And so I want to see if all those are linked together. He was certainly referring to something, and it don't sound good.
Well, McCabe will be raising the right hand, will be under oath on Tuesday on Capitol Hill, testifying before a House committee. He will be asked about all this, so maybe we'll finally get some answers on the very questions, Congressman, that you raise to the American people tonight. Congressman Ron DeSantis in Florida, thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Of course.